Well, one thing I'd like to do is revisit the old National Mower Company, real mower. Few things I'd like to do on this tractor. Few things I'd like to address. One of them is a crack in the motor mount plate. I don't know if you can see it there, but the plate has a little bit of a crack in it, and that's causing some vibration. The motor is bouncing up and down a little bit due to that. So, got myself a nice piece of plate metal, and I'll need to remove the engine and drill some holes in that and remount the motor on a solid plate. The new one is a little bit thicker. I think it's a quarter inch as opposed to what looks like maybe eighth of an inch. Anyway, and while I have the motor off, the other thing I'd like to do is add the reversing belt. This mower has a separate gear here, which I haven't ever had hooked up before because the belt was shredded, and it's used to reverse the mower. So this lever here will engage the belt once I get that replaced. I need to take the engine off to do that. The other thing I'd like to do is try out one of the old reel mowers. Maybe mount the rear mower in back and see if I can get it running enough to mow some grass with it, or at least make a demonstration out of it. The reel mowers are rusty, but they're still there. This is the linkage here that engages the rear reel mower. So if I can do a few of those things and maybe get this spruced up a little bit, it'll be an interesting project. Thread. Very greasy. Should pop right off. All right, the motor's off the tractor now. And now I need to get the plate, the mounting plate, up from underneath the motor. Very interesting. It's you would think it's these top bolts, but the top bolts hold the oil pan on to the base of the engine. Underneath, it's got these flush mounted, I don't know if you can see it, but they're flush mounted screws, which will need to come out. So we'll take those out and we can try to get that plate off. Oh, look at that. Oh, man.
Those are the bottom. Look at that. Huh. All right. So, all I need to do is hold that. The top. Turn the top.
Here's the plate removed and cleaned up a little bit. I always find it interesting the decisions made by the engineers, whoever designed this, can kind of see what's going on here. The holes for the screws that mount to the engine are countersunk on the bottom here, so that we have these tapered screws that fit in, and then that would go up into the engine, hold the engine on. That allows this adjustment plate to slide back and forth to tighten the belts. So I can see where they were going with it, although it doesn't make any sense to me that they would do that countersink in such a thin piece of metal. I mean, that engine has got a lot of vibration to it, and it's quite heavy. So I'm going to be using a little bit thicker here, and I'm going to have to line these up the best I can and cut the same holes. We'll see how that works.
Almost a perfect match. Mark off the holes. Finally got smart, decided to use the old plate as a template. Well, I don't have any way to cut slots. I don't have a machine shop, so I'm just cutting a whole bunch of holes. And I'll have to use a file or something to connect the holes and make slots.
Okay, here's the finished plate. After a lot of work grinding to make these slots, but here's the bolt. Let's slide it. Slide along so that will adjust the tension of the belts, and I'm going to give it a quick coat of spray paint and put it back together. All right, get the old tractor out. Let's see if we can mount the engine and get reverse. Make sure the holes line up here. I don't know. Let's see. Get out some nuts and bolts here. Just put these in. It's going to be tight. I might have to make those slots a little wider. Well, looks like it's working. The new plate slides back and forth. All the slots line up enough. So, now we'll bolt the engine to it. Heavy. All right. First up, the new reverser belt. Hopefully it fits. That looks like it could work. Drive belts. Ooh. Ooh, look at that. That's an interesting discovery. Oh. Oh, man. I guess I gotta put that pulley on a little better, don't I? Wow. Okay. Let's get that attached. Oh, got the pulley tightened on a little bit. Good as we can. Now, see if the drive belts go on. Two. Now, theory is we push the engine forward until those drive belts tighten. All right, we've got the reverse function working by adding this additional belt here. Now we can pull on this lever when the main clutch is disengaged, of course, pull on this lever and it will simultaneously tighten the belt and also engage the smaller gear against this larger gear and it will turn the main drive chain backwards and we'll go in reverse. One thing that I did notice is that there's quite a bit of rattling here, and these two small gears will sometimes rattle against each other when driving forward, when it's not engaged. And I was wondering about that, and I was noticing that it doesn't rattle when you push the lever firmly down and completely disengage that mechanism, but it doesn't seem to stay like that. Then I noticed this strange little kludgy clamp here, which I had always kind of wondered what that was for, and now I'm realizing that if you don't plan on using reverse, you can clip this bar into this little clip, and that'll stop the rattling. So I don't know if that came like that from the factory, or if someone added that later on when they decided they didn't like the sound of the rattling. And you can see the wear on at least that smaller gear there. Anyway, I'm very glad reverse is working on this tractor, and we can start it up and try it out. Thanks for watching. We will get to the real mower in the next video.